Okay, here it is again. It's been a little while. I haven't streamed this since, I think the first time. But I did complete the original trilogy in pre-recorded form.
I need someone to show me my place in all this.
Now, before we begin, someone sent me an interesting series of images. Okay. Here's the first image. Tell me if you can spot what's wrong here. This is from the Switch version of Lego Star Wars, if I'm not mistaken. Tell me if you could just, at a first glance, see anything that may, in fact, be wrong. Jar Jar has no head. Very good, chat members. You've spotted it. You have spotted it. To the point where apparently somehow this glitch has happened to this viewer in various places, and Jar Jar just becomes a floating tongue. Yep. Jar Jar Binks tongue noise. I mean, there's just so many good images of Jar Jar just, you know, being awesome. Give you one more. I think you'll enjoy. I don't know how to get this glitch, but I really wish I could. Anyway. I really enjoyed the original trilogy. You know, it sucks that there's only 5 levels each, but I get why they did that. It's just this game is massive, so fair enough. But we are on the Phantom Menace officially. Even though it's different from the OG games, is it still cool? I think it's very cool.
That's everything we need. We should make our way to the arena and enter young Anakin into the race.
All right. Now we're going to do the pod race scene. It's going to be awesome. But first, I've been informed that there's a way to double the studs that you get. Yeah. It costs a million. I'm saving up for that. Before I buy characters and ships, I am saving up to double studs. What do I need to do here? You know what? As much as I would love to walk around Mos Espa, which I am currently doing right now, I kind of also really want to do the pod race. What is this? Oh, it's the... Oh. Here, let's get the thing. You know, one thing I would say for this game that I wish was maybe... I guess, I don't know how you would improve it for a Lego game, but like a lot of it is get the thing, bring it to the thing, get the item. But I just like exploring these environments so much that I don't even really care all that much. The multipliers all stack. It goes all the way up to times 3,840 studs. Holy shit. Alright, so I need to become... a scavenger to do this. Which means Wicket or Tusken Raider. Wicket. You know, they say there's no rests for the... for the wicket. Chat, it's been a while. How do I switch tools? It... Thank you. Honestly, if episode one had Wicket the Ewok just like shooting nets around Tatooine, it would still be entertaining. Wicket is a pretty funny character. We've had a lot of funny characters, but. Vinny, I thought this was Lumpy you were playing as. That's a thing, by the way, the chat kind of japed me a little bit. I had people telling me that you could play as the Star Wars Holiday Special characters. I thought they meant coked up Carrie Fisher, Plastic Face Hamill, and Harrison Board. No, they meant the Lego Star Wars Holiday Special, which was the sequel characters. I wanted to play as B. Arthur and Lumpy and Itchy. And, like, the person with the volcano head. And, like, Long Solo. Like, Long Face Solo. And, like, Rubber Ford. And also Rubber Fett. But unfortunately, these things are not possible. As far as I'm aware of. I can play as Booba Fett, feet, though. Yeah, Glup Shitto is here somewhere. I haven't unlocked it yet, but. Harvey Korman. Oh, yeah, I remember that, yeah. Tell the Long Luke theory. It's not the Long Luke theory, it's the Bigger Luke theory. There's an actual Star Wars theory that there are two Luke Skywalkers, because they compare the height of Mark Hamill in the original trilogy to that of Han Solo, Harrison Ford. And they notice that he, like, is an inch shorter sometimes, or an inch taller. I think it's an inch. And without telling you too much more, because I don't feel like explaining it in full again, I will just say, Google the Bigger Luke theory if you don't know about this. And you will see that I'm not lying, and there is really a webpage devoted to this theory. They're gonna lose their mind when they fucking learn about shoes. Yeah, but Star Wars shoes. We don't know that. It's actually a common misconception. What it actually is a smaller Han. Yeah, but smaller Han theory doesn't have the same ring to it, in my opinion. Alright, everybody, it's me, Greg Proops! And we're gonna begin the Bunta Eve racing competition. What, did they really get Greg Proops back for this? Yeah, that's Greg Proops from Whose Line Is It Anyway?
Remember, concentrate on the moment. Feel, don't think. Use your instincts.
I will.
May the Force be with you.
Bubska Bulba. Only real Star Wars fans know that the audience are Q-tips.
And there goes Skywalker. He'll be hard pressed to catch up with the leaders today. They're heading into the Mushroom Mesa. Now these are mushrooms I wouldn't want a mouthful of.
That hurt. I think they really got Greg Proops back for this. I mean, if they can get Anthony Daniels, what the fuck is Greg Proops doing? Why not? A couple hundred bucks? I don't know. They did.
It's gonna be tight.
Well, it's no Episode 1 Racer on the N64, but it's pretty good. Wait, is that canonical that there are three laps in the pod race sequence?
Never gonna win unless I reattach it.
Oh boy. Alright, now don't start sending weird fucking, like, social media death threats to the kid who did the voice of Lego Anakin. I think, actually, it was less the fans that fucked with, Jake Lloyd. I think it was a lot of, like, his classmates were just like, "You sucked in that movie, bro!" And it kind of really fucked the dude up. Like, Jake Lloyd has had a hard life since Star Wars. But yeah, I don't know. Listen, people sometimes just, I don't know what percentage of people, maybe it's only a couple, maybe it's a lot, I don't know, but people do, for some reason, have a hard time distinguishing fantasy characters from real life. And they think that by shitting on the actor, that will vindicate their dislike of the character, perhaps? I don't know how that works, but this is, seems to be what has happened. But Vinny, he ruined my childhood. Wait. That wasn't Jake Lloyd that ruined your childhood. That was George Lucas. I mean, Mark Hamill said it best. He did the best he could with that dialogue. Like, Jake Lloyd, he was a kid, you know, and he had to read these fucking clunky lines of dialogue. Harrison Ford once said, "You know, George, you can write this shit, but you can't say it." Yeah, I had the N64 Star Wars Racer. I liked that game a lot, actually.
You knew the boy was going to win. Somehow you.
That's my son!
Bring the parts to the main hangar. I'll come by your shop later on so you can release the boy.
Darth Scary Wary.
Now you can make your dreams come true, Annie.
Shmi.
We haven't much time.
Yippee!
Oh, my bones are aching, Annie. Storms are coming.
Is he to become a Jedi?
Yes.
What about Mom?
Tongue noise.
Is here. It is time for you to let go.
I will come back and free you, Mom. I promise.
Master Anakin, I should prefer it if I were a little more completed.
I'm sorry I wasn't able to finish you, 3PO. Bye.
Oh, my.
Bye, loser.
Anakin, it's time for us to leave Tatooine. Let's hurry back to the ship.
You mean I get to come with you? In your starship?
If Master Obi-Wan not getting Bordo and leaving us here, he's a no liking Jar Jar.
I don't know about that,
God,
Jar Jar.
Fucking Jar Jar
voice.
I'm sure
he thinks you're charming.
Obi-Wan, muy muy grumpy Jedi.
Did I unlock... Wait, who did I unlock? Did I unlock Sebulba? Yeah, it's Phil Lamar. I'm actually kind of surprised Ahmed Best didn't come back to to do the voice. Because he's been... The prequels have been reappraised a bit. No, I mean, I know Ahmed Best has had issues with the Star Wars fandom. I am aware of that. But, there has been some reassessment of the prequels, and people do enjoy them for their, you know, their corniness and fun. And I think that, you know, there's actually a picture of Ahmed Best in, like, a Jedi outfit, and he looked pretty cool. He would have made a good background, like, Jedi character to just, like, you know, not be an annoying cartoon rabbit. That was from his game show. The hell? Creepy protocol droid. He did mocap too, for Jar Jar.
The power of the dark side.
Speaking of Weird Al, I said, "Mama, this here Anakin guy." I don't remember the rest. Maybe Vader someday later. But now he's a small fry. That doesn't fit the meter of the song. He's a small fry. But now he's a small fry. Yeah.
Somehow this resists me.
Now he's just a small fry.
Hello. I am C-3PO. How may I be of assistance? I can certainly be of assistance here.
What the hell's going on here?
Oh, hey. Oh, how wonderful.
Was that a... Oh, Ghost Protocol. First of all, good reference. But, damn, that was actually a haunted protocol droid. That's the ghost droid theory that was made canon. Excuse me, what? No bot? Man, in the 90s, I was so up on everything Star Wars lore. I knew my shit. I had read several extended universe books. I had seen the movies 1,000 times, I read some of the comics, I played the games, and then, like, all these years go by, and there's, like, probably about 45 times more lore. I'm like, fuck, I can't keep up with all of it. Like, you heard the Watto is Anakin's father theory, right?
Hey, and they check you back. When you turn 22, you get wings. All Torodians have wings when they go 22, Annie. You don't know. Shmi was not immaculately conceived, Annie. You know that. There's no such a thing as the Force making babies, Annie. I was your father. She was embarrassed of me, Annie. She never called me back. Annie, please.
Watto, are you really my dad?
No.
My databases have been updated with new hints.
Hey, you there. Want to get someplace else on the planet?
Anakin, drop barrel! Oh! Gooba fish! Go! Go the barrel!
Wow, Jar Jar is better in this game. Oh, that's why the tongue was out in that scene.
Finally, we there you are. Finally, we have revealed ourselves to the Jedi. Follow them, my young apprentice. You know what to do.
But why does a red lightsaber show up on one of those blue hologram devices?
Perhaps we'll actually get to Coruscant this time.
Indeed. However, I believe that stranger may have been a Sith Lord.
A Sith Lord?
Tend to aim for the desert when they're crashing here.
Escort Queen Mamadaman to the Federal District in Coruscant. Next time you land, please spawn young Annie with Darth Vader. They have an interaction. I just did. You mean to tell me there's another one? You didn't activate it? Okay, I'll try again. Vinny, please look up George R. Binks. It's the greatest canon Star Wars character. Vin, have you played Fallen Order? Yeah, I streamed it. That game was awesome. Eagerly anticipating a sequel.
Personal welcome from Senator Palpatine himself.
Let us quickly explain the situation in Naboo, so my people may finally be saved.
Greetings, Your Majesty.
Okay.
Master Jedi.
Do it.
Guess I can't do that now. To the Senate, but we're just gonna walk over to Palpatine. You wouldn't trust a face like that.
It is a great gift to see you alive, Your Majesty. With the communications breakdown, we had begun fearing the worst. I'm anxious to hear about the situation on Naboo. Your Highness, would you be so kind as to accompany me to the Senate to discuss the matter there?
I will say Ian McDiarmid did a pretty good job in episode 1 at coming across like a decent person. And not like a cartoon villain.
Though, I must be frank, he has little real power, and it is unlikely the Senate will act on the invasion. I believe our best option is for Her Majesty to push for the election of a new Supreme Chancellor who can take control and give us justice.
My brain still hurts when I hear dialogue about this stuff. However you feel about the prequels, though, I would say that Ian McDiarmid did a pretty great job throughout. And again, with dialogue and probably like, yeah, we'll just do 2 takes. Like, yeah, that's fine. 2 is good. Can you just, like, give me a little bit more intensity in the eyes? Just give me more eye intensity. George, can we rewrite this? No. Faster, more intense, please.
Ah, here we are. These transport ships will take us to the Senate building. I have some prior business to attend to, so I shall go on ahead. Once you're ready, come find me in my office. We shall proceed to the meeting. Until then.
I wonder how expansive Coruscant is, because there's going to be a lot of stuff that happens here in the prequels. So, the George R. Binks thing, someone said in chat, is that George R. Binks was Jar Jar Binks' father that ended his own life? Because his son Jar Jar was so annoying, and that's apparently canon. He tried to, because Jar Jar Binks was that annoying. Who made this canon? Like, I'm assuming George Lucas isn't signing off on this stuff. Like, he just gave it to Disney. He's like, well, I don't care. It's from an anthology comic. Oh. Oh, okay. If I destroy those, I get a thing. Alright. It was a comic issued by indie artists. Yeah, but other chat members said it was canon, so that they have to be correct. George R. Binks. Well, did you know that Chewbacca is actually a Sasquatch that met with Indiana Jones? Because the Millennium Falcon and Han time traveled back to Earth? And then Han died and Indiana Jones found the wreckage of the ship and also found Chewbacca, who was still alive, as a Sasquatch. Because that's real, by the way. That was in a comic. George was like, whatever, I don't care, it's canon. Did you know that Han Solo got his name because he was alone? Yeah. That's one of those things that I kinda liked the Han Solo movie. I liked a lot of it. A lot of it was cool. Some of it I didn't like. There was... To me, it was like, really? You don't need to say that he's a loner and therefore his name is Solo. It's okay. You don't need to do that.
Are you trying to get to somewhere else? We can get you a vehicle straight there.
I am the Senate.
You're all set. Drive safely.
Yeah, the world building in the prequels is interesting and was expanded upon nicely, and I do like a lot of the weird designs that they employed. Like, they had some very, very talented people working on these movies. Even though some of the sets, especially some of the CG sets in Episode 2, looked like plastic, that was also just a, like, you know, George was trying to push technology. He might have went a little far in a few places, in my opinion, but he did do some pretty amazing stuff with his technology, and LucasArts definitely pushed the medium forward. But some of the bigger sets with the big green screen set pieces look a little bit, like, especially with today's, like, technology, when you look back at it, I'm like, yeah, that's, like, kind of video gamey. Still not as bad as Mufasa being an actual lion.
There you are.
But, you know.
Are you ready to begin the meeting?
Do I get to play the meeting? Simba! I wonder if Lego E.T. will be in the game.
We must do something quickly to stop the Federation.
Order! Order!
Honorable representatives of the Republic, I move for a vote of no confidence in Chancellor Valorum's leadership.
Order! Order!
I've decided to go back to Naboo.
Please, Your Majesty, stay here where it's safe.
I take Anakin as my Padawan learner.
Now is not the time for this.
There's Mace.
Go with the Queen to Naboo and unravel the mystery of the Sith.
Clouded, this boy's future is...
Shortest Jedi meeting ever.
Do you really believe we can convince Boss Nass to help
Super abridged.
What other option is there? I have faith we can convince him.
You should not know a boss like me, sir. He's a stubborn like a farmer.
Encouraging as always, Jar Jar.
I mean, the stuff that I find boring in episode one is pretty sped through. All the good stuff is pretty much just present and ready to be, like, crusted into. I don't understand what's happening here. Oh.
Since I was a boy.
Oh, damn it. Still getting used to, like, the UI buttons. What, see, like, I want it to be Dark Vader.
Your day long remembered.
Where's young Anakin, the child? Where is he? Is he a hero, or is he just, like, miscellaneous? Yeah, he's just miscellaneous.
Whoa,
he's a child.
That's a cool suit. Where can I get one of those?
Patience, child. Patience.
That's awesome. Wow. Someone in chat, Decoy, just had maybe even a better joke. It costs an arm and a leg. Note that Jar Jar just spits. Spit! Jar Jar likes to, attack like a llama. The speedrun strat in this area is literally just to beat up Anakin as Qui-Gon. I don't understand. Why? How would that... What? You juggle him into the air to get a brick at the top of the tower. Oh, you can fly because you can do an infinite combo. I understand. Listen, it's not overly convenient for me to play videos in OBS, so at the moment I'm not planning on clicking any videos. Again, as good as OBS is, and as much as people enjoy it, there are some things that make it very difficult. Like, images have to be downloaded first, and videos have to be imported, and then you have to, like, unmute them. Yeah, Gray Leno we can do no problem, though.
Jar Jar, keep this in. Very shiny.
So yeah, as predicted, Coruscant is pretty massive. There's like many central hubs. What ships do I have? For some reason, I can just use the Tante 4. Just like summon that. It's fine. I got the Razor Crest from the Mandalorian. I don't know why I have this, I forgot. But I have it. I guess this is what we have to... Can I take this? And do the quest with it? Yeah, I just have to go back to Naboo. Lake Pagona. Do you have the Mando himself? I don't think I do. Vinny, restart the game, new DLC unlocked at midnight. Are you serious? It's May the 4th. Mando has been there since day one. Well, where is he? It's not Zuckuss. Mando and Bad Batch DLC. Well, I didn't buy the DLC. Oh, it's a purchase DLC. Wait, am I going to Gungan City, really? God, I need to rewatch episode one. Maybe I don't.
Been deserted.
I pray the boss Nass is still here. Let's visit his throne room.
Who's unlocked the big bubble? Don't Desa know how muy of a head pain it is to open? All the switches and all the walkies. Misa getting tired just thinking about it.
The least amount of time spent in Gungan City, the best. Lest equals best.
There's nobody
just
here.
Smells like slimy, like toad cock.
Perhaps they have.
Down here, you know?
Or maybe they fled.
Of course, sir. Who can hide it? When in trouble, both in one place. Makaniks no find them there. Follows me.
All right, Jar Jar, I'm following. I like that the capes have that little crease in the back. You know, like when you make the Lego cape and it has the little circle? This game tempts me to get another Lego Star Wars set, only to be made fun of by my chat for doing so.
Over here, Misa found a secret entrance. Misa be needing
which one?
Secret key to get in secret place.
Nothing crazy.
Misa know it round here somewhere. suppose we are. But it looks broken. Yusa fixed and used to enter sacred place.
I mean, the throne room I built, that was fun. I don't know. Something kind of like simple, like a more simple set.
Talk about
the Mando one is kind of cool. Then there's the Luke Skywalker hallway set. Jar Jar sounds like Dr. Doofenshmirtz. I don't know what that means, chat member. Vinny, I work with Lego for a living, so I feel you. Bro, you can get me free Legos, you just said. That's awesome. I'm sorry.
I am Queen Amidala.
No. I am Queen Amidala. I am Queen Amidala.
No, I am Queen Amidala.
Dobra Kwikuni Amidala.
I am Queen Amidala.
I am Queen Amidala.
I'm sorry for my deception, but it was necessary to protect myself. If we do not act quickly, all will be lost forever. I beg you to help us.
Did you just step on a toad?
We saw being friends.
Yeah, pulping is awesome. I like to pulp frogs. It's awesome.
Let's head to the palace. We must launch an attack on their control ship and confront the Viceroy.
Gungans will do their part. But if the Viceroy escapes, he will return with another droid army, Your Highness.
That is why we must head to Theed immediately and retake the palace.
What's my part? I want to help.
You help by hiding someone safe and staying alive.
Doesn't sound like
it. Anakin, we're not here to have fun. Which cut of Star Wars is it? Is it the Phantom Edit, where they remove most of Jar Jar and most of Anakin's, like, yippee? I remember that was a pretty big thing. I mean, in the history of Star Wars, one cannot... I think it's kind of almost... disingenuous not to mention the fan edits. Like, it became such a big part of the culture because so many people did their own edits and people were downloading edits and, like, also not just edits, but the restorations of the special editions so that they had the same quality, but basically what was presented on film in the 70s and 80s. Harmy's despecialized editions, which I've seen, by the way, they're really good. There are some special edition changes that I do miss, and like mostly the ship stuff. Like, they fixed up some of the ship stuff that I like that. Just a couple little like touch-ups, but it's kind of hard to find the middle ground because you go special edition and you get like Bantha Poodoo and all the extra stuff, and then, like, the tonsils. But you lose out on the nice little Better Call Maul is the name of this! It's called Better Call Maul! Is the name of this episode.
Annie, find cover! Quick!
How do I call Maul? And will he have a red lightsaber in the hologram? Everything's connected. Saul connected! Chat, I think Saul connected is the new big meme. Put your stocks on that one.
But that's my ship!
Oh shit.
We'll handle this.
We'll take the long way.
Huh?
I think we are all living in the Saul Goodman extended universe and have been for a very long time now. That's what Saul Connected is about. And we will find more connections as time goes on. But, yeah, I've seen the edit where Obi-Wan just falls off the platform constantly. What I was saying before, though, is finding a middle, like, you can go full purity in Star Wars and want, you know, the exact versions of the films that were released in the theaters untouched and you know, in the highest possible film quality. And I think that's cool. I want to see that. Like, that's what I grew up with, the VHS, which still had some changes, but, you know, that's like something that I just think should exist for fans to have, just to see and, like, study. And the special editions can exist, you know, for people that like Bantha Poodoo. And I think a nice middle ground would be better special effects, but keeping it generally kind of accurate to the original visions. Anyway, that's all I wanted to say. Thank you. They're kind of useless. They just kind of like stand there and get killed by the Jedi. Yeah, they don't really pose much of a threat to the Jedi. It's gonna be great. What? What is this? Is this? What is this room? It powers the universe. I feel like there's like several Death Stars worth of power in here. To quote Mr. Plinkett, and Naboo couldn't survive 3 days without space supplies? God, this looks like it powers half the universe. Plasma refinery complex. Oh. Well, now I feel dumb. Should have known. It mints NFTs. Man, I'm gonna complain a little bit more, I'm sorry, but Maul would have made such a good recurring villain for these goddamn prequels. Like episode 2, they could have delved into the backstory a little bit. And like, as we saw him like get his mechanical legs and shit, and then episode 3 he would just be like fucking miserable. Just like a total loose cannon. I get what they're doing now, and you know, I'm just talking about the movies. I'm not talking about like the extended stuff. Uh-oh. That is what Clone Wars did. Well, that's why Clone Wars is so well received. Clone Wars expanded on all this interesting stuff that didn't always have great payoff. Alright, I guess I'm not getting that stuff. Yeah, oh! I just wanted to get onto the floor. You know what? Why am I going to stop them from playing music? Maybe they'll invent a new form of jizz. I don't know. I'm just going to leave them alone. I figured that area wasn't electrocuted because the flooring wasn't fully exposed. Oh, you just can't jump platforms. I've already, you know what? I've already committed to this fight with Maul. I see shiny objects. I wanted to get them. Oh.
Quite the leap. My thighs couldn't manage it. Let's find another way to reach it.
So here's another connected thing. I was just listening to an interview with Liam Neeson today. Just today. He was on Will Arnett's podcast. And they didn't mention Star Wars. As far as I can tell, I haven't finished it, but I don't think Star Wars is going to be brought up. Or maybe, you know what? Maybe it will be. But he did talk about how his thighs couldn't make the jump in Schindler's List. Yeah, the thighs were too thick. You heard what he just said now. Why are we gonna hear about Qui-Gon Jinn's thighs? It's kind of weird. Why are we back down here? Yeah, I know, it's weird. It's just like, I changed characters and then Qui-Gon Jinn teleported back down to Obi-Wan Kenobi. It's weird using a lightsaber on a battle droid and seeing the battle droid survive the lightsaber hit. This does not compute. This scene. Seeing this in the theater as a kid, again, not knowing that there were, like, you know, things wrong with the movie. I mean, I kind of felt like something was weird. But I still enjoyed the movie as a kid. It wasn't until episode 2 that I realized, oh, I think the critics are right. You know, but that's just also me getting jaded. However, the movies were fun in the theater, and I enjoyed seeing this in the theater. And this scene, I remember my heart was racing. I was like, oh man, what's gonna happen? And then Qui-Gon Jinn started meditating, and I was like, all right, that's weird, but he's gonna fucking kick his ass. Vinny, you're allowed to like the movies. Oh, I know I'm allowed to like them. I'm very, very well aware I'm allowed to like the movies. Thank you for permission.
Obi-Wan, raise your lightsaber.
Oh. A battle reserve. All right. Obi-Wan's supposed to be stuck. Obi-Wan, finish the fight non-canonically. Well, that was the good ending. Oh. That's how it happened.
Obi-Wan, promise. Promise me you will train the boy.
Yes, Master.
Your little insurrection is at an end, Your Highness.
Is that also the same voice actor? It is.
Now, Viceroy,
says a chat member. Well, just remember, no one's ever really gone.
We gotta do something, R2.
I was gonna say, I don't remember this from episode one. What the fuck?
We are ready to do Asa part.
We're the warriors. We're the Grand Army.
General Jaja, we must be making our way to the battlefield.
So I guess we're playing as Jar Jar now. There's a code for you to unlock a character. What was the code again? I didn't unlock Darth Maul.
Now, Jar Jar.
BAC1CKP.
Yes, sir. Missa know where they go. Follow Missa.
You did unlock him, you just have to buy him. Oh. Mr. Bones unlocked? I'm sorry, who? Vinny, you missed the Saul reference. No, chat member, you missed me. Making the Saul reference. Do I have to buy Mr. Bones? Episode 1. Scene. Jar Jar and Mr. Bones go from the swamp to Theed Palace. Mr. Bones is a red bounty hunter battle droid. Hey Vinny, I just got back. How's our favorite character, Qui-Gon Jinn, doing? It's fine. It's just fine. Like I said, no one's ever really gone, so. Got a knife? Let Qui-Gons be Qui-Gons. Chat, you're making worse jokes than me.
Me don't need a new helper over here.
Oh, sorry. Dude's got thermal detonators, he's got a knife, he's got a blaster. Something is- there's a thing over here. Oh, I need a Jedi for that. Yeah, we'll just bring Luke Skywalker here. It's still kind of jarring. I don't mean that as like a Jar Jar pun. But is- oh, god damn it. This fucking creature is in the way. It is kind of jarring to have random Star Wars characters from different eras show up in, like, prequels. So what was Mr. Bones from? Just, it was from the books? Okay. A book called Aftermath. Okay. And the joke was that it was a battle droid with a bones on him.
Weezer must hurry!
Captain, Weezer going as quick as Weezer can. Weezer have noticed...
Yeah, like, why Mr. Bones? Such a weird name!
Can Weezer help us find them?
Jar Jar, Weezer must help them to load the wagons. Look around for the boomers.
Okie day. Weezer can count on me, sir.
Only boomer here is this one streaming. Wait, so we're not flying a Naboo Starfighter and destroying a Trade Federation donut, but we're collecting the boomers for General Tarples?
Weezer need this bomber out of the way, so we...
That's probably the next mission. It's interesting how three of the five missions for Episode 1 are like the last half hour of the movie. But I guess that kind of makes the most amount of sense if you think about it. That kind of is where all the exciting shit happens. We got the pod race, we got the initial, like, landing, and the you know, the Jedi going to the thing, the donut. Hey Chet, do you think Top Gun 2 is gonna suck? Kind of feels like something that's gonna just... It's like one of those things that just is just happening way too late. Same for this Avatar movie. I mean, James Cameron does make good movies. It's not that I don't have any faith in the dude to make a good movie. I don't have any interest in Avatar whatsoever. But... like, talk about not striking when the iron is hot. Is Avatar 2 the Overwatch 2 of movies? It'll probably be good. Something tells me the movie is going to be good. This is like James Cameron's life work for the past 12 years. I'm sure it'll be fine. And as for Top Gun, Tom Cruise once said, "Bippity boppity, give me the zoppity. Zenu weenu. Fuck your couch." But he also said, apparently he said there was no way he could do a sequel to Top Gun because it just couldn't be any good. It couldn't be better than Top Gun.
Ho ho! You have found them all. Well done.
We will see.
Now we are ready for battle.
All it done. Times for a well-earned resting.
Jaja, we
Top Cruise.
Getting going. Battle awaits.
Also, I don't know anything about Overwatch 2 other than it has been a disappointment to people. I've only ever played like 8 hours of Overwatch 1. However, they revealed a Warcraft mobile game today, and it's like, yeah, do right by your franchises. Shoot this black nut. Well, consider this. This is... they're giving Jar Jar a mission. And it's like the last thing Jar Jar is gonna do of any consequence throughout the series. God, can I get a better weapon, please? Jar Jar, pick up a fucking blaster! Gungan battle strategy. Just stand back and watch the fight. How have the frame rates been, by the way? Are they a little bit more tolerable this time around? I have frame limiting on via NVIDIA and also the capture itself. It's okay, good. At least it's something. I hear from Lime that it gets real crusty on Mustafar. Gotta say, episode one music, I think I like... I think the original series is my favorite soundtrack. It's like one of my favorite soundtracks of anything of all time. The trilogy, the original trilogy. But if I had to rank like fourth place, oh, or like one that's real close, it's this one. I like it better than episode three, even. You know what? Even episode 2 does have good music. John Williams was still, like, at the height of his game. Episode 9 is not so great, and some of the stuff for 7 and 8 was a little bland, but still okay. But, you know, dude's also 80-something. Ray's theme is good. I like the First Order and Resistance themes. What was this about your memory pickle, Dave? Can you repeat that? Because I can't scroll up. Yeah, I agree with that, Ulrich. It's unfortunate.
Barely, but you're so right.
This is kind of cool. So these Lego games do not fuck around. I, however, happen to be fucking around here because I am taking my sweet time. I've said this before, but a great underrated Star Wars game is Episode 1 Battle for Naboo. It was the sequel to Rogue Squadron. And it was mainly like ground-based missions, but it had some really good missions in the sky too. Like using the Naboo Starfighter and stuff. And it had a lot of this music. It was midified, but it was pretty good.
Giving up, General Jaja. Misa, think of something.
I give up. I give up.
R2, get us off this autopilot. You did it, R2. Look, there they are.
Oh, we do get to. All right, so look, it's almost like I'm playing Battle for Naboo. Actually did well that mission. Never mind. I am a fan of, even though I like that the Razor Crest looked like just junk, I am a fan that of the Mandalorian building a new ship out of a Naboo Starfighter. It's a weird decision, and knowing this Lion King video has made me think a little differently about Jon Favreau, truthfully. But it looks awesome, and it's really fast, and there's a seat for Bab Yod. I still think that they blew their Bab Yod load a little too soon. I think they should have waited before, you know, bringing him back so quickly. Spoilers, sorry. It's been months since Book of Boba Fett now. Wait, he's in that fucking TV show. Dog, two of the episodes are Mandalorian episodes. And then the last one is half of a Mandalorian episode. The other half is a Gray Leno show episode, right? Correct. Well, listen, here on the Star Wars Day, I know it's really, really easy to just jump back into complaints, and I do it too often. But I do love Star Wars. Not as much as I used to, and not as frequently, but I do love it. And this game is just wonderful. It's a delightful video game. I just ignore the Star Wars that's not for me, or that is poop. I'm trying to, at least, even though I talk about it enough for four lifetimes.
I know we're in trouble, just hang on!
And, here on May the 4th, I will say, you know what, life is short, life is tough. Enjoy the things you enjoy. Unless the companies use that to sell their streaming services, and the quality of the product is fucking terrible, and they have writers that don't understand the characters. But that's a different story entirely. Don't worry about that. That's a very unlikely scenario.
If the Gungans are going to win the ground assault, we need to destroy those signal towers.
Come on, R2. Let's shoot those signal towers.
Anakin, we're dying. We'll say, man, once again, that Obi-Wan show, it's the one show that I think people wanted. And I'm hopeful for it. At the very least, I'm very excited to have Ewan McGregor acting as Obi-Wan again. So, you know, instead of being cynical, instead of being cynical, which I usually am, with Star Wars and many other things, unfortunately. I'll say that I hope it's good because I want to enjoy it. Are they doing some kind of like big event? like a political rally type Star Wars event for the May the 4th, or is that just not happening this year? Let us all purchase Star Wars product on this sacred day. This most holy of days. It was another Plinkett thing. I'm sorry. It's too ingrained in my fucking brain. But he likened the Star Wars celebration events to to like political rallies. Like, you go to these things and people are just fucking losing their minds.
It's working, R2! It's working!
But, yeah, I don't know. Is there anything... serious question for the love of Star Wars. I'm gonna ask for real, genuinely. Are we expected to get any announcements? Jedi Fallen Order 2? Anything gaming related? Is that, in the cards? It would be nice. I want to hear about whatever new Star Wars games are on the horizon. Okay, we've been faffing. Now it's time to actually destroy this thing.
We aren't gonna stop this thing from the outside. We gotta get in to do real damage.
Look up the word faff. F-A-F-F. It's not what you think it is, chat members. Means wasting time. It's a Britishism.
Just like racing for Arch Canyon.
Faffing about.
I'm trying to stop.
Those fighters that make it inside the battle station, target any and all power cores. I repeat, target any and all power cores.
All right, Archie, we're looking for power cores. Oops, this is not good.
No, it is not.
Whoa! There are so many droids!
Don't let these guys in here.
Hey, you're right!
We should shit?
This is pod racing.
Oh, we're storing a thing. Oh. Wow.
Control ship has been destroyed.
Sorry.
They are broken.
Yeah, I didn't hear. Let's try spinning. That's a good trick. Oh, this scene is awesome. They give him. Oh, he said it earlier. Okay, sorry. I'm very tired.
Together, we shall bring peace and prosperity.
Said it during your Star Trek rant. I didn't say Star Trek at all. I didn't say it once.
The Council have granted me permission to train you.
Yippee!
There's no doubt the mysterious warrior was a Sith.
Always two there are. A master and an apprentice.
Yeah, the orb. What is this orb? It's like the fucking things that you put your hands on and the lightning touches your fingers. It's a really interesting thing that, you know, because they gave medals at the end of the episode 4 ceremony, so I guess they figured we'll give an orb to a giant fucking frog. Alright. Spinning, that's a good trick. You get a free Lego promo if you buy enough on May the 4th. Do you get a singular minifigure if you spend $100 or more on Lego product on this most sacred and holy of holidays? It's a full set. Okay, all right. You get the Lars Homestead Kitchen. No, I'm not reading this. No. You know what it is. It's episode 2. There's an army of the Republic.
Making our final approach towards Coruscant.
Very good, Lieutenant.
We made it.
I shouldn't have come back.
This vote is very important. Now come.
This is illegal, you know.
We're back. We're on Coruscant. What is the set? What is this? Why am I interested?
Just a cheated hearse. Now let's take a transport to the Senate.
What is this, the free set you get? I'm curious now. I don't know. Vinny, look it up. Alright. It's Watto's shop. You're lying! I would buy something if it was Watto's shop. Vinny Lars Homestead Kitchen. Post a picture of the Lars Homestead Kitchen. Are you serious? I wasn't joking, it really is the Lars Homestead Kitchen. What the fuck? It's got the first Aunt Beru minifig. So how much is that gonna be worth in a couple years? How much are scalpers gonna scoop that up and sell it for thousands of dollars? Alright, maybe not thousands, but... You have to pay $160 to get it? I'm trying to show you the image, but it's not working. It's not working. Free AT-ST Walker. AT-ST? Lars Family Homestead Kitchen is for, yeah, purchase of $160. You have to buy one of the more expensive sets to get it. It's not an individual purchase. If you pay 70 bucks, you get a Beskar Ingyat keychain. When I bought my NES Lego set, I got like four free things with it. I got the NES set, which is not cheap. I don't remember when I got it. 2 years ago? And they gave me like four... Like, what was it? It was like a animals set with bird and things that you could build many things. A car, another car. Speaking of bird, Wingspan European Expansion comes out on Thursday. I will be streaming on Thursday. Get bird hyped. When I first started playing this game, I would just, like, talk to everybody and try to get all these blue things. I have all these blue things, I haven't even spent them. I may as well do some core upgrades. 78 to spend. Three additional health bars. Vinny, you're almost at the studs upgrade. Oh, you're right, you know what? Yes, I will continue to collect the studs. Just set myself back a little bit, but that's okay. We'll get there soon enough.
You need to live somewhere? Safe travels, friend.
You need a data card for the stud thing. I do. Vinny, do you have the Lego remover? It did come with a couple of the sets I had when I got back into them. Now, I should clarify, when I got back... When I say I got back into them, I think I put together a total of four sets. And it was fun. But it's not like when you're a kid and then you, you know, play with the sets. It's like the fun is building them as an adult and then they just kind of sit there and collect dust. At least for me. Oh man, I need a protocol droid. The fact that they're still entertaining as an adult is cool though. Is there a used market for Lego sets? I think there is. I don't know as much as some people do, but I think Lego sets can be sold. Like, especially for people that really, really wanted to get sets that they couldn't. Like an older one, or like an earlier version of the Millennium Falcon or something. Apparently it's a... From what Chad is saying, it is a big market. That's why I actually mentioned the scalping of the minifig, because I know that some people will spend ridiculous amounts of money on minifigures. Some people have stolen Lego sets for money. Yeah, I don't doubt that.
Ah, Senator, we've heard about the explosion on the landing platform. It is a great relief to know that you are okay.
Senator Amidala.
Is that Kieti Mundi?
On the landing platform.
Nice head, bro.
I think that Count Dooku was behind it.
Count Dooku was once a Jedi. He couldn't assassinate anyone.
The subtle removing of the picture in the background was kind of fun.
Master Jedi, may I suggest that the Senator be placed under the protection of your graces? Perhaps someone you're familiar with.
Annie?
Ah! Oh.
My goodness, you've grown.
So have you. Grown more beautiful, I mean.
Is that Matt Launter? Matt, is that him? Chat, is that Matt Launter?
Now that everyone's been reacquainted, allow us to escort you to your quarters, Senator.
Thank you, Master Kenobi, but this seems unnecessary. I don't need more security. I need answers. I need to know who's trying to kill me.
We're here to protect you, Senator.
Probably Lalo Salamanca.
Investigation.
Maybe it's the droid attacks on the Wookiees. I need 2 million for this one.
We will find out who's trying to kill you, Padme. I promise.
Yeah, I know. It's Tidus's voice actor.
My young Padawan learner. I meant it in the interest.
He does a really good job.
Master, of course.
Perhaps with you in your presence, the mystery surrounding this threat will be revealed.
James Arnold Taylor. This is where we walk slow.
Is mine and Padme's company boring you already, my Padawan?
No, of course not, Master. I didn't mean...
We aren't far. My apartment is just up ahead.
Need more studs. Must destroy everything. Well, that saved the galaxy a lot of trouble. Hearing the word apartment in Star Wars just feels wrong. What do you want them to call it? A space place? A flat? I mean, sure, you know... Yeah, I mean, I guess they could call it, like, something Star Warsian. Quarters.
Shall we?
Quarters.
Thank you for getting
living
here
pod.
Safely. Now, if you'll excuse me, I will retire.
I wonder if they have like a Star Wars Wikipedia fact checker extraordinaire for the movies and TV shows. Where it's like, oh, you said apartment. Yeah, we need a spacier word for that. You see, you could say my dwelling. And it's just like one dude with a cell phone. You know? Stands there. Fact checks everything on Wikipedia.
Actually? You see, that's the Darth Vader Senator Palpatine Reconstructive Surgery Center, okay? Now, what you don't know about that place is Vader was built there. His suit was put together there.
On the other end, Star Trek Picard has Picard saying, Guys, I need help in this most trying of times, which we look towards the future.
Stay here.
Okay, everybody. So we're gonna do this.
There she is. Don't let her get away.
So Palpatine.
Be precise with your shots. There are civilians everywhere.
We'll stop her, Master. I promise.
Great. Well, if we could not crash before doing so, I'd greatly appreciate it.
Palpatine
Master, you need to relax.
Hired Dooku.
You've much to learn about many things, my young.
To kill Amidala, right? Palpatine. Is behind it all. But Palpatine didn't want to do it himself. This was a thing I've seen on the internet that I enjoyed. I will do my best to relay it to you. So Palpatine hires Count Dooku and says, destroy her. Right? So then Count Dooku hires a bounty hunter named Jango Fett, by the way, a very competent and strong bounty hunter. So Jango Fett, instead of doing it himself, hires a bounty hunter who can shapeshift but doesn't, not into anything useful. And if you want to go even a layer further, okay, here's the layer further. Instead of killing Amidala herself, the bounty hunter that Jango hired uses centipedes. So, from Palpatine to Dooku, which is a great name, by the way. Almost Dookie. Alright. Palpatine, Dooku, Jango, other bounty hunters, Zaski, Wesley, centipedes. To be fair, if someone sent centipedes for me, that would be enormously frightening. So those lasers were just, like, totally locked on. Vin, this is the opening to Blade Runner. I will say I do like, in episode 2, the look of Coruscant. Like, I'll say something positive. It looks cool. So, I guess now it's okay to shoot. Kill civilians for more money. It's the Jedi way. Oh, you can! Oh, everybody knows the rules. Kill the civilians, no problem.
Look,
before you shoot, Anakin.
No. No, this is lucrative. I had no control over my vehicle at that point.
Anakin, we are Jedi. We must protect the people, not shoot them out of the sky. Keep on then, Anakin.
Has my flying improved, Master?
Well, I'm still alive, so there's that.
Your shooting hasn't, that's for sure. You actually missed just one more layer to the whole bounty hiring bit. Bounty hunter hiring bit? Who did I miss? What layer?
Who hired you?
It was a bounty hunter cop.
Toxic dart.
The droids spit peds.
Back to Naboo. She'll be safer there.
Of course, Master.
R4, I think you can help me with something.
Does anyone have a link to that video? I want to show it. I think I'm pretty much done anyway. It's late.
An old friend at the diner.
Dexter Jetster.
He recognizes this doll, shall we?
Alright. So yeah, I'll show the video. I'm too tired to do the bit justice. I tried. But also I missed a layer. It's just funny. But I do want to explore down here a little bit, because this place... Oh, is this the bar? No. Because there's a bar where they play, like, weird, like, droid sports. Also, these studs are really adding up quickly. It's, yes, Cyberpunk 27. The shrimp lady's here somewhere. Are these shrimp fresh? These shrimp fresh? How about these? Aquafarbs. Okay, I have the thing. I will show the video. But, yeah, so this game, I mean, I've heard the prequels and the sequels suffer a little bit in regards to the gameplay. That last mission was a little simplistic, but, you know, it's whatever. I'm gonna continue streaming these. It's fun. The prequels are providing much memery and entertainment. And again, maybe there's a chance I would do the sequels. There is at least some chance. I have to think about it and see how people are enjoying the streams of this. But, yeah. For now, we'll stick with the prequels. We'll do some exploration, try to unlock some stuff. And I do want to just see as much of the game as possible. I just have to make the decision whether or not I want to go into that... into that rabbit hole. Because, you know, people that are already criticizing me for my Star Wars criticism. Like, this guy is toxic. Like, he just doesn't have anything good to say about Star Wars. Like, I've already seen it. It's fine. Sure. That's okay. But if I do the sequel trilogy, it's going to be a living nightmare for those viewers. So... I'm not sure. I'm just collecting some studs. There are, of which there are very many down here. Alright, do it for the Luke milking scene. And then watch Luke milk a weird fucking alien's tit and then like exit the game and uninstall it.
Show me my place in all this.
Jar Jar is gonna show you. It's Jar Jar. All right. Well, thank you everybody for watching the Lego Star Wars and the Wario. It was fun. It's late now, I'm gonna go, but before I do, here's something from Cosmonaut Variety Hour.
So I'm gonna have everybody try to follow what I was referencing. Along with me.
I need to actually get some volume here, so I can hear it. And here it is.
Real quick. So Palpatine needs Padme dead, but he doesn't want to do it himself, so he asks Count Dooku to go kill Padme. But Count Dooku doesn't want to do it himself, so Count Dooku asks Jango Fett to go kill Padme. But Jango Fett doesn't want to do it himself, so he asks his shapeshifter friend to go kill Padme. But the shapeshifter sends a robot to go kill Padme. And if you really want to be an asshole and get even more granular, the droid says, I'll send these little bugs to go kill Padme. Palpatine sends a man who sends a man who sends a shapeshifter who sends a robot who sends bugs to go kill Padme. And what's even funnier is that after they chase the robot and the shapeshifter, Jango has a chance to go kill Padme. But instead, he goes out of his way to assassinate the person he hired to assassinate Padme. Secretly genius these prequels are. Many original ideas these movies have.
To be fair, they do have a lot of original ideas. I think they do. But, you know.
Valid argument, I have not. Clown emoji, I must send.
Oh, it's just hilarious. That is a crusty Yoda. All right, everybody, have a good night. Real quick, I just want to say thank you for watching. I'll be around soon. Wingspan soon. Why not? And other stuff too and things. So, you know, thank you very much. I appreciate it. And take care of yourselves and, you know, be around soon enough. Hey, also, I know I don't mention subs. I don't call them out. And I don't stream a whole lot these days. Not like I used to. But I do appreciate people subscribing. Sorry I don't call out your names, but thank you for doing that. You don't have to. It's all good. Have a good night. You know what? I should have said, it's all good, man.